गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, लेट्स स्टार्ट आईआईटी वर्कशीट क्वेश्चन नंबर 13। द प्रोडक्ट ऑफ टू नंबर्स इज -28/27। इफ वन ऑफ द नंबर इज -5/95 द अदर। प्रोडक्ट ऑफ टू नंबर्स इज प्रोडक्ट मींस व्हाट आंसर इन मल्टीप्लिकेशन इज कॉल्ड प्रोडक्ट। What is mean by product? Answer in multiplication is called product. So, product of two numbers. So, product. What it is given? Product -28/27. See, in short, I am writing this. It is given. Okay. One number. How much it is given? -5/9. And what it is asked? Find the other. So to find other number. Okay. So what we have to find? Find the other number. What it is? Product of two number is. Answer in multiplication is called product. Answer in multiplication means this product means this is answer of two numbers. So in that one number is -5/9. So find other number. So the number which we don't know, find the other number. So that let that number be x. Let other number be x. Okay. Let the other number be x. We have to find that number. Now what it is given? The product of two numbers is -28/27. This is answer. Answer. What it is? -28/27. This is answer. Product of two numbers. This answer of multiplication is called product. So that what it is? -28/27. One number what it is given? -5/9. What? Product of two numbers. So we have to show here multiplication. Okay. Other number what we consider? X. Let the other number be X. Product of two number is -28/27. Understood? Product of two number. One number is -5/9. Other number we consider X and their product is -28/27. So understand how to write this. First you should understand how to write these. Okay, now see, this -5/9 is here multiplied. If we will transfer to that side, then it will become divide. So x keep here as it is, then -28/27. Okay, -28/27. Now -5/9 is here multiplied. If we will transfer to this side, then it will become divided by -5/9. Okay, divided by -5/9. Okay, so now x is equal to now -28/27. It is divided. So what we are going to do? Reciprocal of -5/9. What it will come? -9/-5. Okay. So now what we can do in this? Lowest term we can do. 9 ones are 9. 9 threes are 27. So here what we got? -28 into 1. Okay. And for denominator 3 into -5. What we will get? X is equal to. See, this is negative and this number is positive. So their product will be the negative. So -28. Okay. Then 3 into -5. 3 5s are 15. Okay. And now if you will see, this number 3 is positive, 5 is negative. So their product will be the negative. Okay. So x is equal to -28/-15. So now -28/-15. This minus and this minus sign get cancelled. So what will remain? 28/15. Okay, so what is the answer? X is equal to 28/15. In option it is given 28/15. Here they have not converted into mixed fraction. So as per option, option 28 upon 15 is the correct answer. Let's solve question number 14. The value of in bracket 2 minus 3 into round bracket 2 minus 3 raised to minus 1 and it's raised to minus 1. So first you should know any number raised to minus 1. Suppose A raised to minus 1. A raised to minus 1. If we want to remove this minus sign, what, how we are writing this number? 1 upon A raised to 1. Okay, 1 upon A raised to 1. We have to remove this minus sign. You are going to learn this in exponents and power. You are going to learn these rules. Okay, these rules are there in the lesson exponents and power. So in that lesson you are going to learn. But now in this lesson, this type of example it is given. So you will find for this. Okay, A raised to minus 1 means any number raised to minus 1. If you want to remove this minus 1. So for that what we have to do? We have to take 1 as a numerator and this number we have to write in the form of A raised to 1. Okay, means we have to remove this minus sign. So same rule we are going to apply in this sum. Okay, so the value of this. So 2 minus 3. Now first what we are going to solve? We are going to open the which bracket? Round bracket. So in round bracket if you will see 2 minus 3, what will be the answer? Minus 1, and it's raised to minus 1 it is given, and raised to minus 1 for this box bracket. Okay, so now what we are going to do, what I said you, 2 minus 3, any number raised to minus 1, this minus 1 we have to remove. So for that what I will see now, 3 here there is no sign means multiplied. Okay, so what we are going to do, this I want to remove this sign. So 1 upon minus 1 raised to 1. See, this minus 1 will remain as it is. This minus sign I have to remove. For that what I have done, I have written up 1 and this minus sign as it is minus 1 raised to 1 as it is. Okay, in detail you are going to learn this rule in exponent and powers lesson. Okay, so now 2 minus 3. Okay, so see here, minus 3 into 1, 3 will come. Okay, this minus sign I have given as it is. 3 into 1, 3. And now denominator minus 1 raised to 1. Okay, minus 1 raised to 1. And its raised to 1 we have to find. Okay, its raised to 1 we have to find. Now, 2 minus 3 upon any, now 1 raised to 1, 1 raised to 1 means 1, it is 1 times, so what will be the answer? Minus 1, and its brackets raised to minus 1. Okay, so now if you will see, this it is minus 2, here it is for denominator, we can shift it for the numerator. See, it is for denominator. If I will shift for numerator, it will come minus 3 upon 1. Okay, it will come for minus 3 upon 1 and raised to minus 1. Okay, so now 2, see, minus minus plus, what will come? Minus minus plus is going to come. There is no denominator for 2 means 1. This is minus minus plus, so plus 3 upon 1 raised to minus 1 for this bracket. Okay, so now if you will see, denominators are same here, there is no denominator means 1 by 2. Okay, denominators are same. This minus minus plus, we open the bracket, so it become plus. So 3 plus 2, 5. So 5 upon 1 means only 5, and it's raised to minus 1. So what I said, any number raised to minus 1 means what it is? 1 upon A raised to 1. So similarly, this is A raised to minus 1 means 1 upon 5 raised to 1 means 1 upon 5. 5 raised to 1 means, you know, na? 2 raised to 2. 2 raised to 2 means what you are doing? 2 multiplied by 2. Okay, means 2 times you are doing. Now here what it is given? 5 raised to 1 means only one time it is. This you are going to learn in exponents and power, but now it is given in these examples, so I have explained you. So this answer is 1 upon 5. So what is the answer? 1 upon 5. Let's solve question number 16. Arrange the following numbers in descending order. Arrange the following numbers in descending order. See, these are the given numbers. We have to arrange them in descending order. See, again, I'm writing minus 2. See, there is no denominator means 1. Okay, there is no denominator means 1. Then next fraction is 4 upon minus 5. Then minus 11 upon 20. And after that 3 upon 4. Okay, so now if you will observe in this for in these numbers, for here and here there is negative sign. For this both the fraction it is given for numerator negative sign. And here for this number it is negative sign. So what we can do? This negative sign we have to shift for the numerator. Okay. See, minus 2 upon 1 as it is. This negative sign we are going to shift for the numerator. So minus 4 upon 5. Again for 5 we will not write negative sign. Okay. Then minus 11 upon 20. And then 3 upon 4. Okay. Now if you will see, these all the denominators are different. So we need to make it same. So for that what we need to do? We need to find the LCM. Okay. If you will observe in this, which is greater denominator? 20. 20 is there in 4 table. 4 5s are 20. Then 5 4s are 20. It is there in 5 table also. It is divisible by 1. What? 20s are 20. Okay. So 20 will be the LCM. Even though I am showing you how to find the LCM. LCM we have to find for 1, 5, 20 and 4. No need to write 1 here. Okay. No need to write 1 because we are not going to find the factors for 1. Okay. 20 and 4. Okay. 5, 20 and 4. Okay. So now 4 is divisible by 2. 20 is divisible by 2, so divide by 2. 5 right as it is, 5, 2, 10s are 20, 2, 2s are 4. Okay, then, again, see now if you will observe, these both the numbers are divisible by 2. Okay, so write 5 as it is, 2, 5s are 10, 2, 1s are 2. Okay, then now 5 and 5, these are divisible by 5. So 5 ones are 5, 5 ones are 5. Okay, so what is the LCM? LCM is equal to 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 5. So 2 2s are 4, 4 5s are 20. So what we got LCM? 20. I told you how to find the LCM directly also. Okay, so LCM is 20. So right here LCM is equal to 20. Okay, so we have to make the denominator 20. So first fraction take minus 2 upon 1. 1 whats are 20, 1 20s are 20. So for numerator also multiplied by 20. Okay. So what we'll get? 22s are 40. See, this number is negative, this number is positive. So their product will be the negative. 1 20s are 20. So this first fraction we have written. Then next is minus 4 upon 5. 5 whats are 40. 5 whats are 20, 5 4s are 20. So for numerator also multiplied by 4. So 4 4s are 16. Okay, 4 4s are 16. See, this is negative, this is positive. So their product will be the negative. 5 4s are 20. Okay, then after that, next fraction minus 11 upon 20. 20 words are 20, 20 ones are 20. So for numerator also multiplied by 1. 11 ones are 11. This number is negative. This is positive. So their product will be the negative. 20 ones are 20. Okay. Then after that next number is 3 upon 4. 4 words are 20, 4 fives are 20. So for numerator also multiplied by 5. So 3 fives are 15, 4 fives are 20. So what answer we got? 15 upon 20 here. Now these numbers, see, we got These numbers we have to write in the descending order. Descending order means what? Big to small. Now in this, which is greatest number? 15. See, positive number is greatest. So 15 upon 20 will come. See what I am writing here. Descending order. Okay, so 15 upon 20 will come. After that, now see, which number will come in this, in descending order? Minus 11 upon 20 will come. Okay, minus, because see, this is greater than this number, minus 11 upon 20. Then after that, minus 16 upon 20. Okay, and then after that, minus 40 upon 20. Okay, minus 40 upon 20. So this we got descending order. Now, 15 upon 20 for which number we got? 3 upon 4. Yes, this 3 upon 4. Then, minus 11 upon 20 for minus 11 upon 20 we got. Okay, then minus 16 upon 20 for minus 4 upon 5 we got. Minus 4 upon 5. Then, minus 40 upon 20 for minus 2 we got. So minus 2 upon 1 or minus 2, both are same. So this is the descending order. Okay. Let's solve question number 17. What should be added to these? What should be added to minus 5 upon 6 so as to get 3 upon 2? What should be added to these? Okay, what should be added? The number which we don't know, that we are going to consider x. So let that number be x. Let the number be x. What should be added? I don't know what to add, so I consider that number x. 2 or 2, 5, minus 5 upon 6. So to get means we are going to get answer 3 upon 2. What should be added to minus 5 upon 6? Minus 5 upon 6. What should be added? Let that number be x. X should be added. We have considered what should be added. The number which we don't know, we consider x. So x should be added to get 3 upon 2. Okay. Now for C, what we can do in this minus 5 upon 6. Yes. Here it is. Minus, if we will transfer to that side, then it will become plus. So x is equal to 3 upon 2 plus 5 upon 6. Now x is equal to, now what is the LCM of 2 and 6? LCM of in this 2 and 6, 6 is the LCM. See here, 2, 6, 2 ones are 2, 2 threes are 6. 3 ones are 3, so 2 threes are 6. So what is the LCM? LCM is 6. What is the LCM? LCM is 6. So make the denominator 6, 3 upon 2. 2 threes are 6. So for numerator also multiplied by 3 plus 5 upon 6. For this no need to make same. Already denominator we have 6. So x is equal to 3 threes are 9. 2 threes are 6 plus 5 upon 6. So x is equal to 9 plus 5 upon 6. Okay, so x is equal to 14 upon 6. Now 14 upon 6, x is equal to what we got? 14 upon 6. Both the numbers are divisible by 2. So 2 sevens are 14, 2 threes are 6. So 7 upon 3. What answer we got? 7 upon 3. X is equal to 7 upon 3. So what should be added to this? 7 upon 3 should be added to minus 5 upon 6 so as to get 3 upon 2. Let's solve question number 18. The product of two rational numbers is minus 9 upon 16. What is given? Product. First write given. Product. Product of two rational numbers is given minus 9 upon 16. Product means what? Answer in multiplication is called product. This is I'm writing in short. If one of the number is, so one number is equal to minus 4 upon 3. Okay, then the other number is what we have to find the other number. So to find other number, other number is equal to how much? Okay, what is the other number that we have to find? Okay, so product is given. One number is given, other number we have to find. So let that number be x. Let the other number be x. Okay, so product of two numbers is this number and other number. It is minus 9 upon 16. So one number is minus 4 upon 3. Product of two numbers, one number and other number. Other number we consider x, and its product how much? Minus 9 upon 16. Product means what? Answer in multiplication is for product. See, multiplication answer is equal to product. Okay, so now if you will observe in this example, see this minus 4 upon 3 is here multiplied. Yes, both of them have, see what, which operation is there? Multiplication. Yes, now minus 4 upon 3, if we will transfer to this side, then it will become divide. So x is equal to minus 9 upon 16 divided by minus 4 upon 3. Okay, now x is equal to minus 9 upon 16. Now what we have to do? We have to write the reciprocal of minus 4 upon 3. What is the reciprocal of minus 4 upon 3? 3 upon minus 4. Okay, so we have written here reciprocal of this number. So x is equal to now minus 9 into 3. 9 threes are 27. Okay, now 9 is negative, 3 is positive, so their product will be the negative. 16 fours are 64. 16 is positive, 4 is negative, so their product will be the negative. So x is equal to minus 27 upon minus 64. So upper and downside minus get cancelled. So what is the answer? X is equal to 27 upon 64. So what it is asked? Then the other number is 27 upon 64.